I can't tell if it's focused or not. He has the force. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I know it has been a very long time since my last upload, but in this video we are going to do a lot of fun things. Let's get right into the video. Know that you're coming back home. So today I'm going to be reading your guys' assumptions about ballet dancers. I asked a bunch of you on my Instagram and I got a lot of responses. So I screenshotted some of my favorites and we're going to go over them and I'm going to discuss a few. Let's just do it. Okay, first assumption. There's more pressure on dancers than any other sport. No, I don't think so. I think, you know, if you're really serious about any sport, whether it's baseball, football, basketball, swimming, gymnastics, there's pressure on it if you really like it and you want to succeed. You know, as long as you want to succeed and you really care about the sport, I think that just adds pressure by itself. Dance, there really is, because it is very competitive, but I think there's pressure in every sport. So I think that's true for a lot of places and things and stuff. Before I was a ballet dancer, I assumed that all ballerinas were stuck up. I also did assume this. I was very intimidated when I first started ballet. I think there's definitely different types of dancers. There's those that are more focused on just go, 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 and I need to get where I'm gonna, you know, where my goal is. But definitely not all ballet dancers are stuck up. We're actually very nice once you get to know us. A lot of people said that I'm intimidating, and I don't think I am. But, you know, maybe it's that same thing. Dancers are perfectionists. You know, I would say this is probably very true, but the ironic thing is that you can never be perfect in ballet, which is a little frustrating because there's always something to work on, but we definitely do lean towards the side of being perfectionists, trying to make everything perfect, trying to, you know, fine-tune every detail that we can, but in reality that is nearly impossible. So yes, a lot of the time dancers are hyper fixated on small details just because we want it to be perfect. So you are right in that sense. I'd say that's kind of accurate. Oh, it just got really dark. Whoa. They are not money focused. You're right. We are not money focused. We are not money focused. Ballet dancers do not get paid as much as they should, in my opinion. Like, people who play in the NFL, NBA, MLB, they get paid hundreds of thousands of dollars, if not millions. And ballet dancers get a very small salary that is just enough to live on. So, you know, I think the arts are underappreciated as always and they need more recognition. So yeah, let's pay our ballet dancers a little more. They work so hard and they bring us such beautiful live art. All ballet dancers have some form of body dysmorphia. I know this is a very touchy subject and I've had a lot of friends who deal with this and still do, but I don't think that all ballet dancers have body dysmorphia. I think, because body dysmorphia is a very wide term, but I think ultimately it's you know, even people who aren't ballet dancers have something that they don't like about themselves, whether that be their nose, their legs, their whatever. Everyone has something that they wish they could change. And what I think about a lot is, you know, it's your body, it's the way you're built. No matter how hard you try to change the way you're built, it's not possible. Like, you can build muscle, you can lose weight, you can do all of that stuff, but the way that you're built is the way that you're built, and you need to embrace it, and you just need to make it work, because the truth of the matter is no one is built like you. So, I don't know. I mean, maybe we all do have some form of body dysmorphia, but people who don't dance have some acute small thing that they also hate. So if you consider that to be body dysmorphia, then we all have it. I don't think everyone does. There are definitely some people who struggle more than others. I think it is so important to realize that what you have been given is what you have to work with and break the glass ceiling with, you know? You started dance at a young age. This is a good one because a lot of people actually do start dance at a really young age, but personally, I started when I was 9, almost 10. So I've only been dancing for 9 years, almost 10. but that is a thing. A lot of people, a lot of my friends started ballet very, very, very early. But it's funny because if you actually look at a lot of professional dancers, like look at Misty Copeland, she started when she was 13. And she's literally a principal at ABT, which is one of the most well-known companies in the world. So it's like, do you have to start that young? Yes, maybe for some. But it just goes to show, if you really love something, and you're really passionate about it, and you're willing to work hard, it doesn't matter what age you start. But that is a good assumption, because I think a lot of people assume that I started really, really young. People often assume that ballet is so easy. This people do. It is the worst when you meet an adult, like a friend of your parents, and you tell them you're a ballet dancer, and then they spin in a circle and they go like that, and you just look at them and you're like, no. Or we work so hard on so many different levels and areas, like people assume that it is the easiest thing. That's why people assume that it's not sport worthy, because we don't work that hard. Which obviously annoys every ballet dancer to another level, but that is a good assumption because I think it happens a lot. People just think, oh, you know, that's like for kids, but it's not. I mean, it is, but not on a professional level. Oh, that we're all obsessive, stuck up, underweight creatures with completely messed up feet. Well, I'd say the messed up feet part is probably true if you're on point. But I do not think that we're all obsessive, stuck up, and underweight. Definitely not. Honestly, I'd say that being the weight that's healthiest for your body is not like becoming a trend, but becoming normalized. Like, I read somewhere a few years ago that a certain school wasn't letting students do YGP unless they were a certain weight, which in my eyes is not good, because if you're a tall dancer, you need the amount of muscle mass to be able to hold yourself up, do those releves, do those hops without injuring yourself. And if you're told to be a certain weight, which is underweight for your height, that's not healthy. Like, yes, obviously the picture perfect ballerina line is very slim, long-legged, and tall, but if you're underweight and on the brink of, you know, damaging yourself just to look like that, it's better to be a little stronger and your correct weight. Being healthy is the number one priority here. Your body is your instrument, and if you're not healthy, you can't protect your body. Now, this is the Christmas haul part of the video. Welcome to that part. Okay, so let's just show you what I got. I asked for these specifically on my list and they came. There are these super cute blue, I'm trying to get it to focus. Is it focusing? These super cute blue Jordans. They're custom. They came from, I think they came from England, but someone made them custom and they're so cute. I literally love them. And the bottoms are blue too. And I was so excited. Okay, so most of you know that I'm like a ginormous Star Wars fan. And I love The Mandalorian. The season 2 just ended. The ending was amazing. And my dad got this for me as a joke gift, but I literally actually love it, like, so much. Like, I carry it around the house. It's a little baby Yoda, and it's life size. And, like, he can do all the little things. He's so cute. Isn't he so cute? He's so cute, and I just carry him around like this. I love him so much. Okay. Moving on. We'll put him right here. There. Next up, I got a little muscle roller, which I really wanted because I used to have one, and now I don't have it anymore, and that's actually really useful. So, yes, dance wear. These are the half cut that are like half sweatpants. They're so cute. I am obsessed. I got these Yumiko Leos that have the skirt attached, and I wore one yesterday for my dance class and I literally loved it. I also got one in pink. Super cute. The lighting's really weird right now because the sun keeps going behind clouds, so Please excuse that. I got a new puffy jacket from North Face. It's basically just like a rain jacket with a hood, but my other one I grew out of because I got too tall and I was wearing it around and it didn't really fit me. So new puffy North Face, which is super good and warm. I've been trying to get better at makeup and I realized that there's one thing that I really just don't have that would just help me get so much better, and that is brushes and the James Charles palette. The colors are literally gorgeous. I watched the Netflix original Queen's Gambit and automatically became obsessed with chess. I've been playing a lot on my downtime and actually playing with a friend of mine who is training from a international master who is in Hungary, which is crazy. So I have been playing a lot of chess, doing a lot of studying of chess openings, middle game, end game. So not only did I get the Modern Chess Openings book from the show, which has all the openings in it, and games that you can replay step by step. Oh, and the pride and joy of my life is my new chess board. It's foldable and the pieces go inside, but I've been playing much chess, even against myself. So that's fun. And I love everything. It was a really good Christmas. Please tell me what you got below in the comments, what your favorite thing was that you got. Thank you for sending in the amazing assumptions. Some of them were true, some of them were not. We have explained everything. And yeah, thanks for watching and please subscribe to my channel. Like this video, hit the little bell to know when I post a new video, which will hopefully be regularly now. And follow my TikTok, which is @LivyJacobus. My Instagram, which is @LivOnPoint with an E at the end.